My grandfather's clock was too tall for the shelf, so it stood 90 years on the floor. It was taller by half than the old man himself, though it weighed not a penny weighed more. It was bought on the morn of the day that he was born. It was always his treasure and prime. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. Pendulum swing to and fro, many hours he spent as a boy. And in childhood and manhood the clock seemed to know and to share both his grief and his joy. And it struck 24 when he entered at the door with a blooming and beautiful bride. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. Grandfather said those he could hire, no servants are faithfully found. For it wasted no time, and it only desired at the end of the week to be found. Sure, the clock knew his place, not a frown upon his face, and his hands never hung by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. An alarm, it rang out in the dead of the night, an alarm that for years had been dumb. And we knew that his spirit was ready for flight, and his hour of departure had come. Still the clock kept the time with a soft and muffled chime, as we silently stood by his side. But it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. Seconds numbering, tick-tock, it stopped short, never to go again when the old man died. It stopped short, never to go again when the old man died.